विकास का काम हो रहा है।
It was mid-May when we thought of producing this documentary.
Time was short and the project ambitious.
I had no idea that such an elaborate project was unfolding. When I was assigned to report on Jammu and Kashmir, I was thrilled.
It was my first visit to Ladakh. This region has always been close to my heart. As I hail from Jammu and Kashmir, and until recently, it was my home state.
You can't even imagine how excited I was.
I have always been in love with Ladakh. I mean, anyone who's been there knows exactly what I'm saying. And here was this opportunity for me to find out what has changed since 2019.
So when the team brought the concept of a documentary on Jammu and Kashmir as well as Ladakh, I was a little skeptical. Ours is not a channel or a website that looks at domestic politics. But then when I slept over it, it occurred to me that Jammu and Kashmir is not exactly domestic. It has international ramifications. So we needed to take a look and review the situation on the ground in both these union territories, whether anything has changed, what are the people thinking there, are the aspirations now sky high and the administration is probably not able to meet those aspirations. That's why this decision to make this documentary.
Hi, I'm Rohit.
I'm Ravi.
Nilanjana.
Shaurya.
Ankit.
Karan.
3 years ago, on the 5th of August 2019, the Modi government revoked the special status granted to Jammu and Kashmir under Article 370 of the Indian Constitution.
Us din se अनुच्छेद 370 के सभी खंड लागू नहीं होंगे.
And not just that, the central government bifurcated the state of Jammu and Kashmir into two union territories, Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. The responses were varied. Some were ecstatic, some in shock, some dismayed, some felt betrayed. Jammu and Kashmir was put under prolonged curfew, internet outage and disruption of communication lines, including mobile and landline phones. The region was under unprecedented shutdown for a long period of time. Kashmir has been a region of international interest for decades, and the region's location makes it clear why. It is situated in the northernmost part of the Indian subcontinent, with China, India and Pakistan all controlling parts of it. India and Pakistan, both nuclear powers, claim the territory in its entirety. Article 370 accorded a special status to the only Muslim-dominated state in the country. Jammu and Kashmir had a separate constitution, its own flag, and autonomy of internal administration. It forbade outsiders to settle in, buy land, hold government jobs, or have the right to education and scholarships in Jammu and Kashmir. These concessions were hotly contested over the years, as these were seen as obstacles to closer integration of the state with the rest of India. The genesis of special status can be traced back to the integration of Jammu and Kashmir into India after colonial rule ended. Under British rule, the princely state of Jammu and Kashmir had a Muslim-dominated population and a Hindu ruler. British rule of India ended in 1947 with the partition of the nation into two, India and Pakistan. Initially, the ruler of Jammu and Kashmir, Maharaja Hari Singh, had decided to remain independent. However, just after Pakistan gained independence, there were several Pakistan-engineered violent uprisings by rebel forces and Pakistani tribesmen, who were eventually making rapid advances into the Poonch and Baramulla sectors. In return for military assistance, Maharaja Hari Singh signed the Instrument of Accession and agreed to accede his state to India on the 26th of October 1947. The United Nations intervened 1 year later in 1948, brokering a ceasefire and establishing the line that still divides Jammu and Kashmir. India started calling the area it administered the state of Jammu and Kashmir, which was given special privileges under Article 370, to assuage the feelings of the majority Muslim community of its distinct identity. But Pakistan always exploited these fault lines and kept on fomenting dissension in the valley. The simmering dissent flared up after Farooq Abdullah became chief minister in a widely believed rigged assembly election of 1987. By 1990, Kashmir was under the grip of Pakistan-sponsored militancy, causing an exodus of Kashmiri pundits from the valley. The three-decade-old militancy is at its lowest ebb with the abrogation of Articles 370 and 35A. New Delhi divided the region into two separate territories directly under the central government's control. Now, Jammu and Kashmir is subjected to the same property and residence laws as the rest of the country. Kashmiri Muslims fear this could spell the end of their Muslim majority character through a demographic change in the region. Militancy is one of the key reasons the Indian government says it took the step.
Article 370 and 35A ne Jammu Kashmir ko अलगाववाद, आतंकवाद, परिवारवाद और व्यवस्थाओं में बड़े पैमाने पर फैले भ्रष्टाचार के अलावा कुछ नहीं दिया।
But violence was not the only reason to revoke the article.
इन दोनों अनुच्छेद का देश के खिलाफ कुछ लोगों की भावनाएं भड़काने के लिए पाकिस्तान द्वारा एक शस्त्र के तौर पर इस्तेमाल किया जा रहा है।
Arguing that its special status was preventing its development and fueling separatism, the government said the decision was necessary to integrate Kashmir and put it on the same footing as the rest of India. 3 years after special status was revoked, what has changed? Our team that went to Ladakh in May spent nearly a week there, covering both Leh and Kargil districts. The second team did a whirlwind fortnight-long tour of the Jammu region and Kashmir Valley in June. Both teams even traveled to forward locations bordering China and Pakistan, covering over 3,000 kilometers. After completing our Jammu schedule, we entered Kashmir via Sinthantop, a pass that connects Kishtwar district in the Jammu region to South Kashmir's Anantnag district.
We're not taking the conventional like main route that people take. We will enter into Kashmir through Sinthantop, and I think we'll enter the Anantnag district.
Road connectivity activities in the treacherous mountain areas are in full swing. In March this year, the government told Parliament that close to 1,800 kilometers of roads had been constructed in Jammu and Kashmir since August 2019.
Kabul, Anantnag.
We chanced upon a hitchhiker who was quite frank with his views.
Road hai, wo bhi theek hai. Light ki problem, wo bhi ab theek ho
gayi. Light ki bahut dikkat thi. Ya kitne ghante rehte the light? Ek do ghanta
rehte the. Ab
kitne der rehti hai?
Ab rehti hai 1 ghanta shift pe kitne din. Yahan pehle bhi acha.
Our next stop, a roadside shop to have salt-laced noon or sheer chai, a popular brew in the region.
Now a guard, if I'm here, I'll tell you. Ravi, will you have namkeen?
Nothing. Huh? Namkeen? Huh? We will try.
Light nahi hai, light jalao.
Chalegi ye light. यहाँ सरकार की नजर अभी मोदी की भी नजर भी यहाँ नहीं पहुंची अभी अभी कोई फायदा सामने नहीं आया
अच्छा
अभी कोई सामने फायदा नहीं है हम भी सोच रहे हैं यही सोच रहे हैं जी मोदी सरकार बोल रहा है तो मगर एक मोदी कहाँ तक पहुंचेगा हमारे पास अभी मोदी का खाली यही राशन पहुंची है जो मुफ्त राशन दे रहा है वो हमें पहुंची है
बाकी कुछ नहीं पहुंचा
बाकी अभी मैंने कुछ नहीं दे रहा
यहाँ से खाली कागज ले जाते हैं वहां से कोई फायदा नहीं मिलता है कभी ये डॉक्यूमेंट दे दो कभी वो डॉक्यूमेंट दे दो खाली डॉक्यूमेंट के काम है बाकी तो कुछ नहीं
कुछ नहीं मिलता
खाली राशन मिलती है वो राशन खाते हैं चाय के साथ जो बात सच है
We drove through South Kashmir's Anantnag district on National Highway number 244, reaching Srinagar late at night. Exhausted and famished.
Reception pe hai koi? हेलो रिसेप्शन पे है
कोई थैंक यू
थैंक यू
Emperor Jahangir had said, if there is heaven on earth, it is here, it is here, it is here. Today, where does Kashmiri identity and culture stand? In these 3 years, has the government secured a grip over the security situation, a prerequisite for restoring normalcy in Jammu and Kashmir? Moreover, has the heartburn and angst dissipated in the valley? What we saw on our entry into Srinagar were tourists almost everywhere. Despite the recent spurt in targeted killings by terrorists, the number of tourists was staggering. Government data suggests that the valley welcomed a record 10 lakh tourists in 2022 till June. Hotels and flights are booked for the next 3 months.
ये सीजन चलता रहेगा बराबर राउंड दे है। पहले आता था टूरिस्ट इधर मार्च अप्रैल मई जून जुलाई तक, अगस्त तक तो रहता था ये यात्रा वात्रा, उसके बाद एकदम ऑफ सीजन रहता था दिसंबर तक, फिर दिसंबर से लोग आते थे बर्फ बर्फ के लिए। अभी दो साल से देखने को मिला कि राउंड दे चालू हो गया।
एंड आई फील दिस इज अ गुड साइन, इंडस्ट्री ट्रेड इट फ्लोरिशेस। Whenever tourists come, you don't see only hotels make business, restaurants make business, shikara wala make business, houseboat owners, even tourist transport, which was defunct, almost defunct, since 3-4 years. Now it we can see there is a certain demand.
Security is tight in Srinagar, including the Lal Chowk area that's frequented by tourists. While there is heavy deployment in and around Srinagar, it is sparse outside the capital city.
There were so many tourists, it made me curious to find out. If this is a facade that masks actual unease and fear,
there's calm on the streets of Srinagar and other parts of the valley. No massive protests. Fewer shutdowns. Stone pelting Fridays have become a thing of the past.
अगस्त 2019 के पहले हर एक साल करीब 40-45 सिविलियन मारे जाते हैं स्टोन पेल्टर, मैंने हमारे लॉर्डर में 2009, 10, 8 इवन 16 में 100 लोग मारे गए एक एक साल में। अभी आप देखें कि कितना बड़ा अचीवमेंट है कि 2 साल 10 महीना में 9 सिंगल सिविलियन मारा गया है। पहले फ्रीक्वेंटली हड़ताल कॉल होता था एक एक सप्ताह, महीना में 5-5 हड़ताल कॉल बंद हो गया, कोई हड़ताल उड़ताल नहीं होता है। स्ट्रीट वायलेंस जो होता था गली कुचे फायरिंग पथरा हो करता था, फिर हम लोग फायरिंग करते थे पैलेट हो, कभी एटीएल फायरिंग करना पड़ता, बंद हो गया पूरा। आप ये देखते होंगे कि इनकाउंटर हो रहा है चारों साइड से पत्थर मारता था, वो सारे बंद हो गया है। जब फिनरल होता था हजारों लोग आते थे, 25,000-50,000 लोग आते थे, उसमें मिलिटेंट आके फायरिंग करता था, टेररिस्ट, सब बंद हो गया।
मिलिटेंसी एंड ऑपरेशंस आर कंटिन्यूइंग, but what we see is that there aren't any street protests taking place. That is one perceptible change that I can see. We don't see any unrest now.
But on ground, there was this feeling of unease, a sense of disquiet. Can't describe it really, but it was there. All three of us felt it.
The recent killings of minorities, migrant workers, local police officials, and a Kashmiri Pandit government employee in the valley have created fear, quite evident at the Pandit colony Sheikhpura near Srinagar. We managed to talk our way to the colony where Kashmiri Pandit employees were in a sit-in protest, demanding security and relocation over the killing of government employee Rahul Bhatt in his office in Badgam's Chadora area in May. We were there after 3 weeks of the incident. The camp, housing over 250 families, remained locked.
इस वक्त हम लोग
Badgam
area में open jail में बैठे हुए हैं। इससे ज्यादा तो मैं बोल नहीं सकता क्योंकि ओपन जेल इसलिए है क्योंकि हम लोग सराउंडिंग सारा बंद है, हम बाहर निकल नहीं सकते। हम लोगों को एक सिंपल से दूध लाने के लिए जाना है वो गेट से बाहर जाना है, सब्जी लाने के लिए जाना है गेट से बाहर जाना है, तो कैसे जाएंगे? पहले ऐसा नहीं,
तो इंसान को जीने का हक है, मतलब सेफ्टी में और हंसने खेलने का हक है। यहाँ पर हमारे सारे हक छीने गए हैं।
If you and me, we can be killed anywhere, any moment, right now, if someone wants,
I don't know if you call that a better security environment, better security climate. I would not agree with that. Anyone is not safe here in Kashmir anymore. In 90s, there was this forced exodus of Kashmiri Pandits. In 2022, there is a requested exodus. Kashmiri Pandits are requesting their exodus. They want to get out of Kashmir.
During the last 32 years, what happened, two major developments, like one was Kashmir conflict, we used to say, another was exodus of Kashmiri Pandits. That is happening again. Situation in Kashmir is as bad as it was in 1990.
After covering Sheikhpura, Rohit had other plans for us. But while we were in Sheikhpura, he chanced upon some of his relatives who advised caution.
आप कभी बड़गाम गए क्या?
मैं अभी जा रहा हूँ.
आ रहेगा.
अच्छा मार.
घूम के आ जाऊँ.
घूम के आज ही आना है क्या?
थोड़ा दफा कर रहा
हूँ. थोड़ा टाइम कंडीशन में.
We decided to visit Rohit's ancestral village, Arigam, in Badgam. Over 20 Kashmiri Pandit families had migrated from this predominantly Muslim village in the early 90s. Rohit's family was among them. Rohit was then an infant. It was like walking into a post-apocalyptic village. Dilapidated, crumbled, vacant houses, and overgrown lots. At the village, some wanted to know what we were doing. Jan Mohammed, a retired policeman, got emotional to know what brought us here. Amid the ruins of the houses of Kashmiri Pandits, a bonding both communities had lies intact.
जब शिवरात्रि होती है क्या बताऊंगा आपका नाम क्या है
रवि
रविशंकर रविशंकर क्या मजा आता है वहाँ वो मजा ही गायब हो गया है यहाँ आप यहाँ कुछ नहीं है सब कुछ लूट ले लिया
तो आप लोग चाहेंगे कि लोग वापस आ जाए
अगर अल्लाह ने चाहा तो आए ये ना ये पंडित इसका नाम है चुन्नलाल पंटा अच्छा ये हमको मजहब की तरफ नहीं देखना वो पंडित है मैं मुसलमान हूँ मजहब की तरफ नहीं देखना देखना इसकी ये कल्चर क्या है यहाँ एक मुसलमान बीमार पड़ गया इसने भीख मांग रहा उसके वास्ते गाँव गाँव में जाया गया
अच्छा
हाँ ऐसा है मैं उसी को कहता है इंसान इंसान होना चाहिए
ठीक
बात है कुछ नहीं आओ जाती हो
All this while, no one really knew who Rohit was. I remember I was shooting inside Rohit's house when I heard the panic in Ravi's voice.
Chalte hain, let's hurry up. Don't disturb him for long. Where's the world is it? Aap
pata nahi kiski nazar lagi is Kashmir ko. Pata nahi.
It was time to move out.
Our hearts still heavy, we moved to the adjoining village of Raithan. This village, interestingly, has had Buddhist ties for several centuries. There's historical evidence that Buddhist monks went to Afghanistan to spread the religion through Raithan. Today's Raithan is known for Ragini Asthapan, the original abode of goddess Kheer Bhavani. The temple is situated on the banks of the Shaliganga River in the form of a single huge rock. It epitomizes communal harmony. It is being looked after by a Muslim caretaker since Kashmiri Pandits migrated from this region. The 95-year-old custodian said, he would look after this place until his death. Next morning, after having our breakfast, we were off to Ganderbal. According to Hindu mythology, the goddess was moved from Raithan to the present-day Kheer Bhavani Temple in Gandharbal district near Srinagar. It coincided with the annual festival for Kashmiri Pandits, for whom paying obeisance at the temple is a way of connecting with their roots. Every year, devotees jostle to pray here. But today, only a few visitors, a fraction of them Kashmiri Pandits.
Third perception has increased. There has been a continuous spray in last 1 week. Four or five people in a row were assisted by the ultras.
अगर यहाँ इस टाइम नॉर्मल सी उस तरीके की होती तो यहाँ कहीं पे आपको पांव धरने की जगह नहीं होती थी, इस तरीके की यहाँ पे भीड़ रहती।
removal was a decisive anti-colonial and anti-imperialist act. This was the pincer hold of those countries, those international powers who wanted J&K to be run the way it was run. The moment Modi did it, he released this. He opened a gate that he was not ready to enter the gate. He again handed over the whole thing to the halfway separatists. He again started. What was the need for a domicile law? They should have allowed at least 3 years, 4 years, for the people to understand that now they are a part of India.
The Union government has been reiterating that there has been decisive control over terrorism since the abrogation of Article 370. However, there seems to have been an evolution of militancy through the emergence of homegrown militant outfits and local recruitment. They attack soft targets, heightening the sense of fear among the local population, migrant workers, and elected officials.
5 August 19 के बाद हम देखते हैं यहाँ देखते हैं तो अभी तक में लगभग 2 साल 10 महीना हो गया इसमें 107 सिविलियन मारे गए हैं 107 सिविलियन में 20 हिंदू हैं जिसमें 4 कश्मीरी पंडित हैं 3 सिख हैं और 84 मुस्लिम्स हैं टेररिस्ट के जब देखते हैं तो ये 495 प्लस मारे गए हैं और इसमें जितने भी पुराने टेररिस्ट हैं लश्कर तैयबा का जैश मोहम्मद का चाहे एलईटी का सारे मारे गए
The emergence of hybrid militancy poses a new challenge to security forces in the valley.
They changed the strategy to target killing, the hybrid bar, using boys who are sympathetic to terrorism but who are not listed as terrorists. One group does not know about the group B, B doesn't know about group C. So something like that. These groups are basically being mobilized, given small weapon and go for soft targets. Low investment, high return. Low investment in the sense that in encounters, the terrorists, they were losing their men, they were losing the weapons. But here, you don't lose anything.
The abrogation of Article 370 was executed with unexpected ease. But it has triggered this new kind of terrorism. The induction of local youth into the ranks of militant groups has been largely driven by a sense of alienation, marginalization, and anger. These young activists, both in their 20s, pursuing degrees from Kashmir University, gave us a sense of radicalization and how deep-rooted it is. Rehmat, who believed he was born for jihad and to become a martyr, told us about his transformation from a hardcore, angry stone pelter to helping radicalized Kashmiri youths come back to the mainstream.
They spoke candidly and gave us a glimpse of the dark reality of the J&K Kashmir.
हमारी जमात बैन भी हो गई, जमात इस्लामी बैन भी हो गई, but जमात is doing है, जो जमात पहले काम कर रही थी, उससे बढ़कर वो काम कर रही है। सर आज आपने जब घोषणा पारित कर दी सब पूरे कश्मीर में approximately के सर approximately minimum हजार से ज्यादा स्कूल जीते होंगे जो नर्सरी से लेकर 12th तक पढ़ाते थे। वहाँ पे क्या पढ़ाते, वहाँ पे को एजुकेशन है, लड़कियाँ भी आती है, लड़के भी आते हैं। और वहाँ पे मैं एक एग्जाम्पल देता हूँ कि महात्मा गांधी जी का एक लेक्चर होगा, महात्मा गांधी जी को बोला कि इज अ फादर ऑफ नेशन, जब ये बच्चों आपके एग्जाम्स के लिए है, बच्चे बुक बंद कर दी बैग में रखी, अभी रुको एक मिनट, जो हमने पढ़ाया जो फादर ऑफ नेशन है, ये असल में फादर ऑफ नेशन ही आपके एग्जाम पास कराने के लिए फादर ऑफ नेशन है। जो असल में जो फादर ऑफ नेशन है अली मोहम्मद जिन्ना, ये बच्चों पे आज के यू नो कश्मीर के बच्चों पे नाम है जिन्ना, जिन्ना एवरीबॉडी नोज जिन्ना।
व्हाट दे सेड नेक्स्ट इवन शॉक्ड मी।
नाउ आई विल टेल यू देयर इज अनदर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन द मोस्ट इंपोर्टेंट, वी आर कॉलिंग देम फलाउदारी, वी आर कॉलिंग देम इंटेलेक्चुअल ग्रुप ऑफ पाकिस्तान। So who they are you know, intellectuals, they are professors, they are IPS officers, they are KS officers. ये वही से आते हैं, इस सिस्टम से आते हैं और फिर सिस्टम में आते हैं सर। अब what they are doing, now they are identifying people in जमाते तुलबा, जो उनको लगता है कि जो कैलेबर जो IAS क्वालिफाई कर सकता है, जो IPS क्वालिफाई कर सकता है, बिकॉज उनको 90 से इनके सिस्टम में पूरा सिस्टम आ जाए सर। मैं तो बताता हूँ कि दैट कहीं ना कहीं तो ऑन ग्राउंड पाकिस्तानी स्कोपली जो टेररिज्म कम हो गया, या साइकिल से सिक्योरिटी बहुत चीज़ें स्टूडेंट पैडिंग बाकी चीज़ें, जो पाकिस्तान अभी जो है ना, पाकिस्तान हमारे सिस्टम में बैठा है।
But there is hope. People are cognizant of the malaise that has festered for decades.
हम लोग नहीं जाते हैं, हमारे हमारे तो मजहब में भी नहीं लिखा जिसको हम फॉलो करते हैं, हम ये ले जाते हैं हमारे बच्चों को इधर उधर भटकाते हैं, हम नहीं चाहते, हम चाहते हैं कि हमारा बच्चा डॉक्टर बने, ये बने, उसके पास फैसिलिटी
करें।
तो वो भी वही चीजें जाते हैं कि प्रोग्रेस प्रोग्रेस की तरफ।
We spoke to several young people to understand why stone pelting incidents have largely gone down, and so have large funeral processions across the valley. They refused to speak on camera, but disclosed that the Jammu and Kashmir Public Safety Act was keeping them away from such activities. Since 2019, the security forces have enforced this law against suspected militants with increasing severity. Under the Public Safety Act of 1978, any individual deemed a threat to public order or threat to national security can be detained for up to 2 years without a trial or charge. In Baramulla, a terror-infested area of North Kashmir, we met a former militant and stone pelter who is out on bail, fighting several legal battles, including the PSA.
In 2008, को मुझे PSA लगा दिया गया और उसके बाद मुझे सीधे कुठवा जेल पहुंचाया गया। जब मैं जेल में पहुंच गया तो जेल में मुझे बहुत ज़्यादा टॉर्चर और तशद्दुद का निशाना बनाया वहाँ के उस वक्त के SP साहब ने। अब आपका सवाल यह है कि मतलब यहाँ पर ये हालात कैसे ठीक हो जाएंगे, नॉर्मल सी कैसे हो जाएगी। देखिए, जो आज की यूथ है, आज की यूथ सोचने और समझने वाली यूथ है। आज की यूथ ज़्यादातर अफवाहों पर कान नहीं धरती है। यहाँ पर अच्छे अच्छे प्रोग्राम्स होने चाहिए, यूथ को इन्वाइट किया जाना चाहिए, कश्मीरी को मौका दिया जाना चाहिए, एक प्लेटफॉर्म उसे उसके सामने रखना चाहिए। आप बोलो, आप पेश करो, आप अपनी बात रखो, आपके क्या मुतालबे हैं आप रखो, बातचीत करो।
The union government has been vociferous in its contention that post August 2019, development, establishment of democracy and peace at the grassroots are taking place. Indicators like employment, infrastructure and investment are showing promising prospects, but on the ground, things are not so bright. The overarching sentiment, the uncertainty of the future.
Kashmir has always been stuck at the same place. It's like stuck in the same time. Nothing changes. But there's a rapid shift with 370. There was some a radical change that happened. And with that came unpredictability, which is something that Kashmiris don't like inherently. We like knowing that we will be safe.
There could have been sweeping changes in the administrative system in the newly formed Union Territory, but that has not happened.
There's an absence of democracy here. We need a proper elected government here. This bureaucracy, whatever is happening right now, it is not going to work and it is not working. There's a huge disconnect from the top level to the bottom level. There's a huge disconnect. There's this complete bureaucratic rule that is happening here and it is ruining things. Things are not in shape.
Although the center held elections for the district development councils and panchayats in 2020, these institutions are still in a fledgling state and require extensive guidance and empowerment, which is missing.
We met the elected members of Sopian and Pulwama districts of South Kashmir in our hotel.
They've been put up in government accommodations and hotels ever since the election. They haven't even visited their families back home. That's not the case in Jammu region.
We were also advised not to venture out.
South Kashmir is better to avoid Shopian area. Kafi and a hotbed of militancy.
Acha, so I should avoid it.
Without security, you should avoid it. Without security cover, security अगर issue sort out हो जाता है ground level पे कि आपको कोई security मिल जाती है तो फिर आप सोच सकते हैं उस बारे में.
We managed to visit a few panchayats in Badgam district near Srinagar.
जहाँ तक हमारे इस पंचायती राज का ताल्लुक है जम्मू कश्मीर के हवाले से, इसमें कोई शक नहीं कि ये थ्री टायर सिस्टम जो है ये पहली बार बना है पिछले दो साल में. पहली बार इसका कॉन्सेप्ट यहाँ पर बहुत कमज़ोर था और यहाँ अवेयरनेस पब्लिक में नहीं थी. पिछले तीन साल में यहाँ जो हमारी सरकार है मरकज़ में, तो उन्होंने बड़ी कोशिश की कि यहाँ पर जो ये थ्री टायर सिस्टम जो है मजबूती के साथ जो है इम्प्लीमेंट किया जाए. इस हवाले से ग्रास रूट लेवल तक छोटे छोटे काम जिनकी बहुत ही ज़्यादा ज़रूरत है पेरिफेरीज में, गांवों के अंदर में, मॉलों के हैमलेट्स के अंदर में, तो इस थ्री टायर सिस्टम के ज़रिए काम ही सही लेकिन वहां पहुंचे जहां पहुंचने का डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल पर कोई हमारा अंदाज़ा नहीं था.
Almost two dozen panchayat members have been gunned down by terrorists since the grassroots governance institutions were restored in the valley. It is tough for the security forces to provide security to each DDC or panchayat member, and placing them in safe houses defeats the purpose.
When I didn't visit my constituency, meri 25 panchayats aate. It is near about 60 villages and a population of almost 50,000 people. जब मैं उस एरिया में ही नहीं गया हूँ जिसके प्लान के लिए मेरे को दस्तखत लिया जाता है कि मुझे डेवलपमेंटल वर्क है जी, यहाँ वो नाली बनानी है, वो मैंने देखी नहीं है कभी, वो रोड मैंने देखा नहीं है, वो स्कूल मैंने देखा नहीं है, तो हाउ इट इज पॉसिबल कि आई विल गिव द जस्टिस टू माई पीपल.
मेरा काम है काम आइडेंटिफाई करना, लेकिन जो ये डिस्कोरस एक होना चाहिए, एक इंटरेक्शन होना चाहिए पब्लिक और रिप्रेजेंटेटिव के बीच में to fix the priority in village. किस तरह हम पैसा खर्च करेंगे अगर ये पैसा आया है, वो मशवरा ही कहीं पे नहीं होता है, that is missing. क्योंकि जब उस तरह से हम इंटरेक्ट ही नहीं कर पा रहे हैं ग्राउंड पे कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी में, हमारा कसूर ये है कि हमने इलेक्शन लड़ा, उठाओ जेल में भर दिया, यहाँ से आप बैठो श्रीनगर में, किसी को होटल में बांध, किसी को उधर बांध, किसी को इधर बांध.
The erstwhile mainstream political party's power has diminished. An opportunity has been created with the DDC and panchayat elections, creating a new generation of leaders not seeped in the glib mindset of exceptionalism. But they haven't yet been able to fill the vacuum. Even so, a certain degree of transparency has started creeping in the administrative system. Efforts are being made to distribute jobs evenly between the Jammu and Kashmir regions. Development projects are also being distributed between the two regions more equitably than in the past. Jammu region comprises the plains, hills and mountains in the mighty Pir Panjal ranges and is the only approach to the Kashmir Valley. The pristine beauty of the hill districts of Poonch, Udhampur, Dora and Kishtwar is as stunning as the Kashmir Valley, which are yet to be developed into tourist hotspots. A majority of Jammu's population practices Hinduism, comprising Dogras, which ruled the region for a century, while Islam and Sikhism enjoy a strong cultural heritage in the region.
पूरा देश 15 अगस्त 1947 को आज़ाद हुआ बट हमारा जो जम्मू कश्मीर है ये 5 अगस्त 2019 को आज़ाद हुआ सबसे पहली बात।
जम्मू को सबसे बड़ा स्वाभिमान ऑनर मिला, डिग्निटी मिली जो जम्मू के लोग मिस कर रहे थे 370 से।
डाउट एनी डाउट जम्मू इज नाउ गेटिंग इट्स शेयर ड्यू शेयर in all in every respect from infrastructure point of view if you see investment point of view if you see tourism point of view if you see economically
for decades there has been a long standing demand in Jammu for separate statehood due to allegations that the region has been discriminated against by the valley based leadership and even now people here say their conditions won't improve.
Jammu had a sense that we are being discriminated on account of religion and region by the Kashmiri Hajj. Now, after the approbation of Article 370, BJP is in power at the center. BJP is ruling the JNK, and BJP also, in a sense, represents the aspirations and the feelings of the Jammu. So they have this feeling that yes, our voices are being heard, our voices are dominating. But how real and tangible they are, that's a secondary thing.
The gulf between Jammu and Kashmir remains intact. The Jammu and Kashmir administration claims it has received investment proposals worth over 51,000 crore rupees, which have the potential to generate nearly 2.5 lakh jobs.
Our private players have developed here new, you know, private industrial area for the investors to invest in Jammu and Kashmir. But on ground situation is quite different. See, this is the problem. This is the problem with the government also. They just want to, you know, they just want to showcase the Kashmir first. And we as a Jammuites, we are still struggling.
If you're talking about Jammu, here nothing has changed in terms of any economic development, which I should call.
They are calling investors right from Dubai and Abu Dhabi, and they are taking into from Srinagar, making them to stay in Lalit Grand, and then showing them where you have to make investment for hotels or other development projects. They are not coming. Why they are not bringing them to Jammu? What is here? What is the problem in Jammu?
The changes, whatever the government intends to bring, it has to be incremental and piecemeal. Don't let this sense of insecurity flare up in the people of the Jammu region. They should not feel have this sense that we are getting economically disempowered. Politically, you may make them empowered, but at the end of the day, when elections will be held, when statehood will be given, then again the equation will change dramatically.
Jammu appears to be fending for itself in the absence of business opportunities. local traders are visibly unhappy.
पीक टाइम है बिजनेस का, अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 7 बज रहे हैं, तो यहाँ पे आप देख रहे हैं कि कोई कस्टमर है? कस्टमर का इनफ्लो यहाँ पे हमारे पास फुटफॉल कितना दिन का, आजकल 1, 2, 3 मैक्सिमम 4 कस्टमर आ जाएंगे, उससे बाकी तो दूर है कि दुकान के अपने खर्चे नहीं पूरे होते, दुकान का चाय पानी नहीं पूरा होता। कमजोरी इसमें लीडरशिप की है खाली।
इट्स नॉट ऑल ग्लूमी दो, डेवलपमेंट वर्क हैज स्टार्टेड लुकिंग अप।
जितना पैसा आ रहा है हम लगा नहीं पा रहे, हमारे पास इतना सिस्टम नहीं है, हमारे इंजीनियरिंग विंग इतने अभी क्षमता नहीं, उनमें इतना पेशेंस नहीं है पैसा लगाने का, तो पैसे की कोई कमी नहीं है। हर जगह यही एक आवाज़ है, जो हमारा इंजीनियरिंग विंग है उसको स्ट्रॉन्ग कर रहे हैं और उनको एक गति उनकी कैसे तेज हो, बार बार मीटिंग्स कर रहे हैं और सिस्टम को चेंज कर रहे हैं। और आज ये मंदिरों के शहर से ये शहर जाना जाता था, आज इंस्टीट्यूशंस के नाम से जाना जाता है।
We have IITs, we have IIMs, and we are also, I think, we'll be hosting lot of foreign universities, private universities. They are all contemplating to come, and because now it is an open region, this UT is now open for all sorts of investments. So we are hoping that we will find a lot of good investments in the education sector as well, and that would actually increase a healthy competition, and the students would have a wider choice where to take admissions and what sort of options they want to explore.
But students we tried speaking to on Jammu University campus were evasive and more concerned about future job prospects.
पर से एजुकेशन अगर हम लें तो हमें कोई ऑन ग्राउंड कोई चेंज नहीं होता है, 370 है या नहीं है, बिकॉज जम्मू इज ऑलवेज बीन वेरी पेट्रियोटिक।
और है कोई अपना बता,
तो ये फील होता है कि ओके, अब जैसे पाकिस्तानी फ्लैग वगैरह वो सब आप वो नहीं कर सकते हो, अब जैसे कश्मीर हो उसको लेके अच्छा लगता है, बट उससे आप देखो हमारे फ्यूचर प्रोस्पेक्ट्स का कुछ, दैट हैज गॉट नथिंग टू डू। सोशियो पॉलिटिकल चेंजेस जो हैं वो आए हैं एंड दे आर वेलकम चेंजेस।
हम खुश थे कि 370 हटेगा तो एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेट होगी, प्राइवेट सेक्टर आएगा और भी बहुत सारी चीज़ें डेवलपमेंट होगी, पर
नथिंग हैज हैपेंड सिंस द रिमूवल ऑफ अली हसन।
एम्प्लॉयमेंट के जो वादे किए गए थे वो भी सारे के सारे कहीं पे तो दिख नहीं रहे हैं।
Sports is another area which seems to be making a turnaround in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. Through the Prime Minister's development package, 200 crore rupees has been sanctioned to boost sports infrastructure, provide training facilities with the latest utilities and professional coaching. People here don't seem to care as much about the abrogation of Article 370 as they do about losing their statehood. The refrain we heard as we traveled through Jammu from Udhampur to Bhadarwa and further to Kishtwar on the way to Kashmir was that the Union Territory status is a temporary measure and statehood will be restored after elections are held.
लोग अभी उस माइंडसेट से बाहर नहीं आ रहे, एक ट्रामा सा है लोगों में, अब क्या होगा, अब क्या होगा, बट अब थोड़ा सा वो स्ट्रीमलाइन होगा, लोग थोड़े रिलैक्स फील कर रहे हैं कि नहीं कुछ नहीं है, ऐसा कुछ नहीं होगा, अब वेट कर रहे हैं कब एक पॉलिटिकल प्रोसेस स्टार्ट हो, और ये तो एक वो है ना बिगिनिंग है, लोगों का माइंडसेट चेंज हुआ ये तो साफ दिख रहा है।
the Indus or Sindhu, the river from which India gets its name. And this region was part of the erstwhile state of Jammu and Kashmir till 3 years ago. Ladakh has a long history and has been at the crossroads of High Asia for centuries. The original settlers were from Himachal, Gilgit, and Tibet. After being ruled by several kings and being amidst several power struggles, let us move forward to the 19th century, when Sikh rule had been established throughout the north of the Indian subcontinent. However, Jammu and Kashmir was under the stewardship of a Dogra ruler, Maharaja Gulab Singh, whose general Zorawar Singh entered Ladakh in 1834. The then king, Sheshpal Namgyal, was deposed and exiled. Ladakh came under Dogra rule and was integrated into the state of Jammu and Kashmir in 1846. There was constant strife by Ladakhis to regain their freedom. This bloody period ended with the advent of the British. Despite Ladakh having two semi-autonomous hill councils, the people had raised voices of dissent against the Jammu and Kashmir state government, saying governance does not reach them in terms of funding, as well as delivery of schemes, and local aspirations were ignored.
एक डिमांड हमेशा ये रहता था कि हम जम्मू कश्मीर में तो रहते हैं लेकिन लद्दाख को अपना जो राइट थे उनको इन टर्म्स ऑफ फंडिंग में कहें या अदर वो कभी आपको नहीं मिला जितना कश्मीर को मिलता था या जम्मू को मिलता था
In 2002, all political parties merged to form the Ladakh Union Territory Front, and the demand for union territory status began.
Hill Council was given, but the power was not there, actually. It was just like, you know, rubber stamp kind of thing. You know, we were not given proper power there. By 2000, again, there was some different kind of agitation here, and people then again started demanding union territory again, and they disbanded all the political parties and they formed a LUTF. And then how in 2002, when the new government came in, came to power in Jammu and Kashmir, so they empowered this Hill Council in 2003.
Things went smooth for some time, but the winter of 2018 saw a lot of political agitation in Ladakh as the two districts of Leh and Kargil demanded that Ladakh be made a division. On the 8th of February 2019, Ladakh became a separate revenue and administrative division within Jammu and Kashmir, having previously been part of the Kashmir Division. And then came 5th of August 2019. Ladakh became a union territory without a legislature.
It is a demand ever since independence for a union territory in Ladakh. And I feel that this need was expressed for one major issue, which is that I want to do development my own way.
Finally, the 70 years long dream struggle was fulfilled, you know, and you know, it became a reality in 2019. So now, you know, we can dream, we can have a vision, you know, we can plan something and we can fulfill those.
And indeed, Ladakh is seeing a major infrastructure overhaul.
You see these towers, guys? These were not there the last time I was here.
Last 2.5 years, ever since we became Union Territory, I think more than 70 villages has been connected with the mobile telecommunication. Electricity has been improved. You know, grid line has been connected almost in the entire Ladakh, you know, except for Nubra and some part of the Changthang. Now roads are being built up, you know, proper good roads, blacktop roads, you know, and clean drinking waters are being provided to the people in the rural sector, you know.
I think the standoff in Eastern Ladakh in 2020 gave a renewed relevance to Ladakh in terms of operational and strategic importance. It is imperative for the government to develop Ladakh.
New tunnels and roads are being carved out in the tough terrain of the Himalayan region. where temperatures plummet to as low as minus 40 degrees Celsius. The terrain may be mountainous, but the soil is fertile and irrigable. The focus is on organic cultivation and irrigation through solar pumps.
Tail business per diye Goodman ne agriculture ki taraf se. Pehle to wo polythene wala greenhouse mein banate the. Wo usme to kamin nahi hota nahi. Sardi mein raat ko jam jate hain. Din ko zyada garmi lagte hai to.
Efforts are on to grow a variety of high value crops, increase yield and facilitate exports. And in the process build entrepreneurship and create diverse jobs.
ये पॉली जो हम फ्री देते हैं फार्मर्स को जी तो उसके साथ हम सीड्स देते हैं इसका वाटरमेलन मसमेलन टमेटो उनका सीड्स देके हम डेमो देते हैं यहाँ पे आके
morning 5 in the morning we're about to leave for Kargil
let's go
for the record we're 14 minutes late but it's
Education is another thrust area. We visited several schools in Kargil where students as well as teachers are gung-ho about the facilities being provided to them.
Welcome to Kargil!
At the school level, higher standards have been set by disassociating from the J&K board and moving to CBSE.
हमें जो ICTs मिले, computers मिले, बच्चों को tablet वगैरह मिले, वो अभी recently दो तीन साल में हो चुका है. बच्चों में ज्यादा कॉन्फिडेंस बिल्ट अप होता है ऐसे चीजों से ना
इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर बहुत बढ़िया मैं प्राइवेट स्कूल से आई हूँ पहले तो अपॉर्चुनिटीज कुछ ज्यादा ही मिलती है यहाँ गवर्नमेंट स्कूल्स में एज कम्पेयर टू प्राइवेट स्कूल अब देख सकते हो गवर्नमेंट स्कूल में इतने ज्यादा अच्छे अच्छे जो है टेक्नोलॉजीज है वो सब है जो प्राइवेट स्कूल्स में नहीं मिलते तो इन सब फायदे को देखते हुए मैं यहाँ पर आई हूँ
At the higher education level, the University of Ladakh has been set up. A new medical college and an institute of hotel management in Leh and an engineering college in Kargil have been planned. However, there are lots of issues to be dealt with and teething troubles have academicians worried. Ladakh students lost reservations that had been granted in universities and government colleges of Jammu and Kashmir.
We are resisting the administrative and financial control of
the
University of Ladakh. Most of the teachers, they wanted to maintain the status quo. They wanted to remain as state government employee.
Because we have been recruited by the higher education department, right?
Of the so
my parent department is higher education. Now, obviously people are like obviously we don't want to go with the for a time being right because it's a new university
and we have a lot of apprehensions
yes,
regarding
because everything is not very clear
just like in Jammu and Kashmir another major thrust is in the area of sports Ladakh has got its first open synthetic track and football turf. Built at a cost of nearly 11 crore rupees, the stadium has enthused sportspersons. For athlete and marathon coach Sering Stobgyas, it's a dream come true.
I went to Delhi for study, so there I found sports culture, which we didn't have that time. So I found it very lucky, those people who run and they get jobs, scholarships and all. Then I want it here, like when we have a special stadium like this, they get more motivated. They come here, they know how to play, they know how it is, like what is stadium all about.
They know the distance, most importantly.
Despite claims that New Delhi is focusing on Ladakh's development after years of neglect, the very visible and robust infrastructure overhaul is triggering both hope and fear among the local people. While it fulfills a long-standing desire of the people of Leh, complaints remain.
We spoke to many youngsters and they were worried about job security, especially government jobs.
जब हम J&K में होते थे तो हमारे पास बहुत सारे एवेन्यूज़ होते थे लद्दाख के यूथ्स के लिए. फॉर एग्ज़ाम्पल, हमारे बच्चे जो हैं आपका पब्लिक सर्विस कमीशन, JKSSRB, J&K पुलिस, J&K बैंक, कहीं पर भी वो लोग अप्लाई कर सकते थे. तो अनफॉर्चुनेटली जब क्या हुआ, आपका बाइफ्रिकेट जब हुआ तो जम्मू कश्मीर में उन्होंने अपना डोमिसाइल लगा दिया. लगाने के बाद हमारे जो लद्दाख के यूथ हैं वो किसी भी जॉब में वहाँ अप्लाई नहीं कर पाते.
जॉब मिलने में बहुत प्रॉब्लम हो रहा है सब जगह से, पंजाब, हरियाणा, देहरादून, मसूरी, सब जगह से. यहाँ जब फौजी में भरना हो तब भी आता है, पुलिस में भरना हो तब भी आता है, कुछ जॉब होगा उसमें भी भर देता है, लेबर में कुछ भरना होगा मिलिट्री के अंदर उसमें भी भर देता है, फिर यहाँ के लोग रह जाते हैं.
In both Leh and Kargil, what was really palpable was the sense of disappointment and uncertainty, especially in the Hill Council. It was almost as if the autonomous Hill Councils felt they were being undermined by the central administration. They lament that not only was this decision taken without the consent of the cross-section of the people here, but also there is no proper demarcation of their scope of power.
There are certain things need to be done, you know, to make, to avoid the chances of confrontation, conflict of interest, kind of things, you know. In Hill Council Act should be amended in contextual of Union Territory, you know, because earlier in the district, the DC was the, Deputy Commissioner was the topmost officer. So he is the CEO of Hill Council, right? But now there are a lot of secretaries, you know, and the DC has become a junior most officer, and he is still the CEO of the Hill Council, you know. So if pass on some order to my CEO, so at times it becomes difficult for him to further pass on that order to the secretaries.
Ladakh is without a legislature. It has also lost 4 MLAs, 2 MLCs and 2 cabinet ministers that represented the region in the former state of Jammu and Kashmir.
वो पब्लिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन जो है ऑलमोस्ट खत्म हुआ है आपका. अब रहा आज के डेट में पूरे लद्दाख में 1 member of parliament and 2 councils.
Furthermore, there is no clarity on the role and responsibility of the Hill Development Councils and the Union Territory Administration.
तो हम बार बार एक ये डिमांड भी कर रहे हैं कि एक बिजनेस रूल आ जाए आपका, जिसमें ये क्लियर कट हो कि काउंसिल के क्या लिमिटेशंस हैं और यूटी एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन के. अदरवाइज अभी बहुत सारे चीजों में थोड़ा सा क्लैश भी है.
The elected representatives of village panchayat say separation from Jammu and Kashmir in 2019 has brought in a new phase of development.
हर फील्ड में आपको मैं बता दूं कि हमारे डेवलपमेंट में कहो, पंचायत डेवलपमेंट में बोलो, पंचायत इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर में बताओ, हर फील्ड में जो है पहले से बहुत इम्प्रूव हुआ है. और जैसे फंड्स का मैं बता दूं तो फंड्स भी बहुत सफिशिएंट फंड्स पंचायत को आ रहा है.
हाउएवर, डिस्पाइट लद्दाख बी इंटीग्रेटेड इनटू द 73rd अमेंडमेंट, पावर्स आर नॉट डिफाइंड.
जो भी यहाँ से बने हैं हमसे, अगर 73rd अमेंडमेंट ना हो भी, गो यहाँ पर एक्ट लागू ना होने के बावजूद भी, हम आपस में मिलजुल के एक दूसरे से मदद लेके
हम आज तक काम करते आएंगे और आइंदा भी हम करते जाएंगे.
The Union Territory Framework in Ladakh is still in a fledgling stage and will take time to function as intended.
The government processes at the secretariat level were not quite known here. And therefore, whether for the government itself or for the councils, it became a challenge that how do we proceed. But I'm happy to say that 2.5 years, 3 years down the line, I think most processes have been streamlined.
The initial anger and sense of betrayal that the people of Kargil had seems to have subsided.
लेह के साथ तो हमारा ज़बान एक है, हमारा खाना पीना बैठना सब कुछ. तो अभी रियलाइज़ ये हुआ है कि लोगों, क्योंकि जो कुछ करना है हमें आपस में लेह और करगिल दोनों मिल के एक करना है. अभी आपने रिसेंटली देखा होगा, दोनों मिल के अब एक स्टेटहुड की मांग कर रहे हैं, या ये बोल रहे हैं कि नहीं जी स्टेटहुड हो या आपका यूटी विद लेजिस्लेचर, ताकि जहाँ पर लोगों की रिप्रेजेंटेशन हो.
वी सेव द बेस्ट फॉर लास्ट, टूरिज्म द बैकबोन ऑफ लद्दाख इकोनॉमी.
Ladakh's landscape is unique. So is its culture. Harmonious coexistence between Buddhists and Muslims is part of its ethos. Despite the harsh weather and sparse vegetation, the area is rich in wildlife diversity. Add to these pristine rivers, wetlands, and rich grasslands. No wonder it draws hordes of tourists both from within the country and abroad.
Xin chào.
Ladakh has a population of nearly 4 lakh. This year it hopes to receive over 5 lakh tourists. The hope is that it would help recoup some losses induced by the pandemic.
Everybody started investing into tourism, especially in late 2017-18 onwards. So then, you know, some people they took a loan and they constructed camps, some constructed guest house, some constructed hotels. Then suddenly this COVID came, you know. So the COVID was actually a very disastrous situation for the people of Ladakh. But then fortunately, you know, tourism again started, and somehow, you know, people are managing to recover it.
Times like the third go first is coming.
We are at the highest operational air base in Leh.
The Indian Air Force that operates the Leh airport says it is prepared for the large number of domestic flights. But an increased number of tourists also means added pressure on the environment.
You can't have a very large scale tourism here. The tourism here ultimately would have to be niche and high value. Biggest change that is required is how we educate, how we get the cooperation of the entire population, and how do we deal on this matter with the tourists.
The administration is working towards sustainable tourism. Solid waste management plants and sewage treatment plants are being planned. The regulation of guest houses has begun.
A very great help for Ladakh was the prime ministerial announcement that Ladakh would follow the path of carbon neutrality. Now, this is the path which has permeated the entire thinking, the entire decision making for Ladakh.
Lovely to meet you.
Same here.
We are now maintaining data
all the tourist hotels or those who are being which are being constructed have to have certain NOCs, especially with related to the sewage treatment, with related to the electricity. They need to have a solar backup also. So certain directions have been given, and I'm sure it is being implemented as well. We do joint checking from time to time.
The Ladakh police has been sensitized to establishing a separate tourist police wing. A huge challenge here is communication and the lack of a mobile network.
So there is a large chunks outside Leh, which are like, 200 to 300 kilometers you have to cover, and then there is no network, and if something happens, we do not get informed immediately. We have posted our highway patrols vehicles there, and our jawans also live there, so that if any help is or rescue has to be done, they are immediately reachable, they are immediately able to communicate.
The Union Territory framework is expected to shift Ladakh's development paradigm significantly, which needs to accommodate the region's social and ecological vulnerability. All three regions, Jammu, Kashmir, and Ladakh, appear to be on the cusp of change. Booming tourism, economic activity, increased investments, revamped infrastructure, and a people fearless about being targeted for cooperating with the administration. But a shaky administration, apathy towards people's aspirations, and the overarching sense of insecurity and anxiety, especially among the most vulnerable sections of society, are plain to see. Nevertheless, the people seem to have reconciled with the new reality. The central government may do well to keep its ear to the ground.